The Final Fantasy series is no stranger to having playable villain characters. Final Fantasy VII gave you control of Sephiroth during the Nibelheim flashback. Final Fantasy VIII gave you temporary control of Idea. Beatrix was temporarily playable in 9, and Seymour got to creep a little too close to Yuna in 10. In Final Fantasy VI, the closest thing we have to playable villain characters are Biggs and Wedge at the very beginning. And maybe Leo if you're using an exceptionally broad definition of villain. But our primary villain, Kefka, is never playable. Which makes sense, since the guy has a basically 0% approval rating even within his own faction. No one wants anything to do with this guy. So what if I told you that, at least in the PC version of the Pixel Remaster, you can get him in your party anyway? Getting Kefka requires exploiting two glitches present in the Pixel Remaster version. The first is the title screen glitch, which those who watched my Leo recruitment video may be familiar with. But when I get to the point where I need to use it, I'll go through the setup steps again anyway. The second glitch is the resize bug, which is present in all the Pixel Remasters, not just 6. When you resize the screen during an event, the event will stop executing the next time the map screen changes and will also place your party on that map. The game itself does not allow resizing the window or changing the resolution while the game is running, but you can bypass this by opening the Windows display settings and changing the window scaling to some other value and then back. So, with that background information explained, let's use this knowledge to add Kefka to the illustrious roster of playable villains. First, we're going to need to prepare 4 save files. You can have them in any save slot, I'm just numbering them from earliest to latest in regular gameplay order. But we're not going to be using them in that order, nor are they the numbers of the save slots I'm using. The first save should be on the overworld outside of Themasa, after you've named Strago and Realm, but before you've done the Leo event. This first save is also going to be the base save, meaning it's the party and game progression data that's going to carry through each step, and also the game data that Kefka is eventually going to join. The second save needs to be in the Esper Cave before the 3 trap doors, the last place you can do a hard save before the Leo event. If you've tried running the Leo glitch from my previous video, you already have this one. The third save needs to be after you've completed the Leo event in Themasa, but before you've gone to the Floating Continent for the first time. Again, if you've tried the title screen glitch already, you probably already have this one. Finally, the fourth save needs to be in Daryl's tomb, with the fight with Dullahan already completed. After you beat Dullahan, instead of proceeding down to the Falcon, go back out and save at the save point instead. First, we're going to load the third save, before the Floating Continent, to set up our quick save for the title screen glitch. Head to the Floating Continent and make a party of your 3 weakest characters, and don't bother to equip them since we want them to die fast. As soon as the screen loads with you on the airship deck, walk back and forth 4 times. On the 4th time, when you get back to the helm, open your menu and set your cursor memory to on. Then, quick save and return to the title screen. We need to hang on to this quick save for the entire rest of the process, so don't use any other quick saves or it will overwrite this one. Now load the 4th save in Daryl's tomb. Head up 1 room into the room where you fought Dullahan, then exit back to the title screen. This will generate an autosave in that room in Daryl's tomb. Now, reload your quick save on the airship before the Floating Continent. As soon as it loads, open your menu and place your cursor on Configuration, Return to Title Screen. Because we set our cursor memory to on before we saved, it will keep these options selected the next time we open the menu. Now, quickly exit and enter the menu. The goal is to open the menu at the exact same time as the dialog box appears that starts the Imperial Air Force battle. This takes frame-perfect timing, so if you miss it, just let the battle start, open the pause menu, return to the title screen, then select your quick save to try again. Just remember to reset your cursor position to configuration, return to title screen at the beginning of every attempt, since that won't carry over. There we go. When you get the timing right, the dialog box for the event will open over top of the menu. Since we had our cursor position saved, click twice to select Configuration, Return to Title Screen, which will simultaneously advance the dialog box as well. If the game doesn't transition to the battle by the time you have the Return to Title Screen dialog up, just click on the event dialog box with the mouse to force it to advance. Once you're in the battle, the title screen dialog box is still up, but your controller and keyboard are now back in control of the game screen in the background and not the dialog box. So you need to make yourself die in this battle. Once you die, although the title screen box is covering it, you'll get a prompt to reload your last recent save data. The recent save data it's suggesting is actually the autosave in Daryl's tomb. The selection defaults to yes, even though you can't see it, so just confirm that selection. So now we've reloaded in Daryl's tomb, and the title screen dialog is still blocking most of the screen. So refer to the minimap in the top right corner to navigate around the gravestone and into the back room to start the cutscene with Setzer. You're going to have to go through almost the entirety of this cutscene with the title screen dialog in the way. After it shows the bird flying to Miranda, Celis will tell Setzer to follow it. When this dialog box comes up, use the mouse to click twice on yes on the title screen dialog to escape the event and return to the title screen. Now select your first save outside of Themasa after naming Strago and Realm. Go into town and interact with this barrel to the right of the item shop. It doesn't matter if it's empty or gives you an item, we just need to trigger an event that has a single dialog box to get the event queue running again, because that event we escaped on the airship still isn't finished. Walk away from the barrel so you don't talk to it again, and the screen will eventually fade out, taking us to a fascinating new place. While you're in Godzilla mode, get in a random battle, and the monsters will just let you in because they don't want to mess with a 50-foot lock. But doing so will also clear all the funky states that this teleportation caused, and will make the remainder of the cutscene of following the bird finish. But now, when you check your party, you'll see that it's still your party from Themasa, and not Celis, Edgar, and Setzer. What's more, if you go below deck, you'll see that you still have basically all of your party members available except Shadow. Heck yeah, we've already got the whole party back together! We can go to Kefka's tower right now! Which is actually what we're gonna do. But your party levels, abilities, and equipment are still from the world of balance. And we're going to need to build up one party, just enough that they can beat Ultima Buster. But this is the only fight in Kefka's tower that's going to be mandatory to do. So, once you've got your Ultima Buster busting party ready, head to Kefka's tower. Party 2 is your Ultima Buster party, while parties 1 and 3 can be anyone, since they're not going to do anything. Once in the tower, switch to party 2, and turn off encounters if you want to. Head down to the dungeon where Ultima Buster is and fight him for his save point. Once you beat him, save your game to a new file, then exit to the title screen. Now, load your second save, in the Esper Cave before the three trap doors. If you've done the Leo glitch, this next part is going to look pretty familiar. Fall through the bottom trapdoor and proceed to just inside the entrance to the cave where the espers are, then quit to the title screen. This will generate a new autosave at this location, like we did with Daryl's tomb. Now, go back to your quick save on the airship, because it's title screen glitch time again! Bang your head against the menus a dozen times until you get them to overlap, then kill yourself in the ensuing battle. When it asks you to reload your recent save data, confirm, and you'll reload in your autosave in the Esper Cave. Use the minimap to walk down the path until you trigger the event to start. Let the event play until the screen glows, then fades out and back in, and everyone's changed position. Once you're a few lines of dialogue past this point, use the mouse to click yes twice on the title screen overlay to escape this event and return to the title screen. Now, load your save data with your Ultima Buster team from Kefka's tower. It's important that you turn encounters off at this point, because if you get in a random battle here, it will clear the glitched state. Walk up out of the dungeon, then up to the next room to this treasure chest and talk to it to get the event queue running again. Turn away from the treasure chest so you don't accidentally talk to it again while advancing through the remaining dialogue, or it will freeze the game. After it tells you to go talk to General Leo, your party will get teleported back to Themasa, except now Leo is in your party. He's wondering where the heck everyone went, since we teleported them all to the end of the game without him. At this point, leave town and turn your encounters back on, because we need to get Leo in a random battle to refresh the game state. Like before, the monsters will just let him win, because he's Leo friggin' Kristoff. Now, take him back to town, and the Themasa event will begin to play as normal. Unfortunately, we need to send Leo to his fate, because we're here for somebody else this time. Hi, Kefka! Have you ever perhaps considered renouncing your evil ways and joining the Returners? No? Well, too bad, because we're going to make you. After Kefka kills Leo and the screen starts to shake when the Espers awaken, this is when you need to pull up your Windows display settings to activate the resize bug. Set your display scaling to something like 125%, then back to 100%. Then proceed through the event. But when the screen changes to show the sealed gate, instead of showing the Espers escaping, Realm is just kind of there. There really isn't anything we can do at this point since the menus are also locked, so hard reset the game. But when you reload the game, you'll see that Realm at the sealed gate is still there in your autosave, so go select that. Now you have game control back, but the sealed gate map isn't a real map that's normally accessible, so it has no exit. So how do we get out of here? The answer is in the lower right corner, and why we did all those shenanigans with Kefka's tower before coming here. Because we illegally warped our Ultima Buster party out of Kefka's tower, it never disabled three-party mode, so we can still switch between parties no matter where or when they are. So have one of your other two parties just leave Kefka's tower, which will consolidate all of your current party members back on the airship. Okay, but that party at the sealed gate was still just Realm, Terra, Locke, and Strago. So what about Kefka? Well, go talk to one of your party members on the airship and see who's in your roster. It seems Kefka disguised himself as Locke and snuck on board while all of us were unawares. So for people sitting there wondering what the hell just happened, let me back up and break down what we did and why. We started with a party that had named Strago and Realm, but had not yet completed the Leo event in Themasa. Because Strago and Realm are present for the Leo event, if their data isn't initialized at that point, it freezes the game. Also, if we had started with a party that was already at Kefka's tower and warped that party back to Themasa, that game would have had the Leo event already flagged as completed, and won't let the event proceed beyond Leo getting knocked out by the Magitek armor. So that's why we had to take the base save and warp them to the World of Ruin, and then back. But we needed to warp them to the World of Ruin with access to an airship, which is why we pulled them into the Daryl's Tomb event. Then, we needed to send them to Kefka's tower to put the game in a three-party state, then warp them back to Themasa to run the Leo event. The three-party state is necessary to escape the sealed gate map and reconsolidate the party without actually finishing the Leo event. But why is Kefka in the party in the first place? Unlike Leo, he's never a party member. This is technically true, but also technically not true. Every time Kefka appears as a sprite in the battle window, he's actually added to your party. It's just that he's always an AI party member, like Cyan was in the Imperial camp, and you therefore never have control of him. But because he was in his sprite form in the battle window when he killed Leo, at that moment, he was technically a party member. And because, if you'd let this scene proceed normally instead of stopping it at the sealed gate map, he then fights a reskinned Ifrit, so he remains a technical party member for that span of time. But we interrupted the event while he was still a party member, allowing us to kidnap him. Alright, Kefka Destroyer of Worlds, let's see what you've got. Well, you've got 10 HP. And you're level 1. And you can't equip anything except a Mithril Shield. And your job class is just Kefka. Alright, no problem, you can equip Espers, so let's go level you up to that god you know you are. Well, crap. Yeah, so Kefka can't level up from level 1. He can learn magic, but he'll only ever be able to cast spells that cost less than 10 MP, because he can't equip relics like the Celest Triad either. But hang on, if sprites that appear during battle cutscenes are treated like party members, there was one other person who appeared during that cutscene, so why didn't we get him? Well, actually, we did. Sort of. Gastal doesn't have a full sprite sheet like the rest of our characters, so he's not even visible in the party menu. Unlike Kefka, he can't even equip anything at all, and if you take him into battle, because of his lack of sprite data, he'll just freeze the game for performing an illegal celebration dance. Therefore, Kefka was quite correct when he called Gastal a useless old man. But Kefka himself isn't much better. Sure, you can take him to battles and teach him magic, but he can't equip anything, can't level up, can't actually use most of what you teach him, and dies in one hit. So instead, we're just going to sentence him to a life of community service, rescuing the people he terrorized. And if he relapses into his evil ways and decides to kill a sickly old man with bad fish, he will at least learn remorse and take care of himself accordingly. And finally, he can face himself as a new man and self-reflect on his actions. So while it's funny to run events with him, that's about all he's good for, because he's otherwise functionally worthless. Which I'm sure really bruises his ego. Oh, you know what else we should do that would bruise his ego even more? Hey Kefka, you know that guy you killed? Well, he's back, and he can level up. He can equip anything, and he is just better than you in every conceivable way. And you're just going to have to wallow here in your impotence while he outshines you. Because that's what you deserve. Because the best revenge isn't just living well, it's forcing your enemies to watch you do it. Thanks for watching.